Just stop me.
So sometimes you want to help people. For example, you give counsel to a woman, let's say she's involved in some affair, you counsel her, but then you yourself become involved with her. Or you tell people not to take drugs, then you yourself become a drug trafficker, you also take drugs. So like, you join them instead of helping them. So we should be very careful. So secondly, if we think that we are somebody, sometimes we think they are very spiritual. Especially those who are long time Christian, they think they are very spiritual. So the Bible said, we must not deceive ourselves. Okay? We should judge each of our own conduct. Of course, some people will judge us. It's good to listen to others. But in the final analysis, we must judge ourselves. Right? Okay. We should judge ourselves. Not necessary for us to compare with other people. Because we want to compare other people, so difficult. We must judge ourselves based on what we learn from God, based on the Bible. Okay? And we should share all the good things we have with our teacher. Are you sharing your good things with your teacher? Who are your teacher today? Here we are talking about spiritual teaching. Your pastors, your CT teacher or your PK teacher, right? So we are talking about spiritual. But of course, we should respect other teachers. Your teacher teaching you in your lecture, geography, history, maths, or anything. Okay? So once again, we remember this law of sowing and reaping. This is not only true in the spiritual sense, in physical sense. You want to sow durian, you must have durian seed, right? You cannot reap a rambutan tree if you drink a durian.
Yeah.
So whatever you sow, you will reap.
All right,
so in the Bible, so even if you don't study, of course you cannot get good marks. If you study hard, the chance is that you will have good marks. So you sow what you reap. So the spiritually, if you keep on watching, let's say you are watching pornography or you learn all the things that don't go into violence, you will also become violent. You also become sexually immoral. So it's very important for us to know what we are sowing. Okay, we must be careful of our nature. There's two nature in us, which we learned earlier. Our human nature and the spiritual nature. So if we sow towards the spirit, for example, do good, love, all these are the spiritual side. The nature side is anger, okay, cheating, greedy, and all those things. So if we show towards the anger side, the flesh, we will reach the desire of the flesh. So let's come to the final warning. So what's the final warning?
See what big letters I make as I write to you now with my own hand. The people who are trying to force you to be circumcised are the ones who want to show off and boast about external matters. They do it, however, only so that they may not be persecuted for the cause of Christ. Even those who practice circumcision do not obey the law. They want you to be circumcised so that they can boast that you submitted this to physical ceremony. As for me, however, I will boast only about the cross of our Lord Jesus Christ, for by means of his cross the world is dead to me, and I am dead to the world. It does not matter at all whether or not one is circumcised. What does matter is being a new creature. As for those who follow this rule in their lives, may peace and mercy be with them and with all of God's people.
Okay, so finally, in conclusion, okay, because the Jews, the main problem is this, they cause circumcision and they obey the law and they obey the law and they want They want to be circumcised, all that. But of course, today, what is our main problem? Our main problem may be our ancestral worship, or we follow the religion we came from. And we cannot 100% change over. Christianity is through faith in Jesus. We are all a new creation, right? So it's not by what we do. A lot of Buddhists, for example, they think that doing good works, you know, that they will accumulate a lot of good works, and then they will go to heaven. A lot of Hindus think that they think it's all karma. So we should change our thinking. It's by faith in what Jesus has done. Of course, we continue to do good. As a Christian, after we are saved, it won't save us. Of course, Paul is talking with a lot of credential because he has suffered for his work. He has been submitted to a lot of physical torture. Okay? So he has carried the cross. So he only boasts about the cross. So to conclude, we must focus on Jesus Christ. Okay? We must focus not so much on what people think about us, say about us. We must follow to do what God wants us to do. Okay? So, let's pray. Father in heaven, we thank you for this, your word, and revelation, Lord. Help us, Father, to not follow our natural human nature, but help us, Father, to live according to your Holy Spirit. Help us, Lord, in Jesus' name we pray. Amen.
Amen. Amen, Nigel.